5:30, they take cooking right to the street, but are food trucks gobbling up traditional restaurants' profits? This potential turf war is prompting Baltimore city officials to propose some new rules for food trucks.
Yeah, and that has left some owners of these mobile eateries unhappy about the situation. 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer joins us live from City Hall with a look at this kitchen controversy. Lowell.
Yeah, City Council Committee was supposed to have a hearing earlier this morning on this zoning issue, which basically says that food trucks would now be forced into assigned areas only around the city. But lack of a quorum and controversy surrounding this proposed legislation led to the hearing, to a postponement for the hearing.
The Gypsy Queen Food Truck is an all-too-familiar sight parked near the University of Maryland Medical Center Tuesday, but a new zoning proposal by city officials could change all of that.
Well, I think it's a solution looking for a problem.
Owner-operator Tom Looney told 11 News while preparing lunch that the city's proposal to set up zones around the city just for food trucks, limiting where they could set up shop, isn't fair, and it's plainly not good for business.
As we understand it, might corral us into just certain locations and not be able to go out and service our customers.
Right now, food trucks pretty much have free reign of the city as long as they stay 300 feet away from restaurants. And this, both restaurant owners and food truck operators say, has been a relatively happy marriage. Drew Pumphrey, owner of the Smoking Swine Truck and vice president of the Maryland Mobile Vending Association, says the city needs to give a little, meaning operators would be okay with the zones, but would also like to be able to service their regular spots.
We would like to see the zones that are proposed by the city, but we would like to see them in conjunction with being able to park in regular metered spots as we do now.
Brian Mathias, who runs the Bistro Lunchbox food truck off of the MICA campus, agrees.
People look forward to us showing up at those places. You know, as long as we respect other people's businesses and establish our own clientele, I think it's all fair.
To further complicate things, the bill has more than 50 amendments and has been petitioned, so city officials are going to take a closer look. Pumphrey says that's a good start.
If we can get the rules and regulations worked out, we can all come to an agreement where everyone wins, I think it's going to be great.
City officials say that they will set up a work session where they can actually sit down with not only the food truck operators, but also restaurant owners as well, to try and see if they can come up with a compromise. That date will be sometime in the next 30 to 45 days. We're live downtown outside of City Hall. I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL-TV 11 News.
Interesting controversy, Lowell. Thank you.